Welcome to Blackboard 9, Learning at Griffith. On the right hand side is the edit mode on and off. This will give you an idea of what the students see. You're currently looking at a course site that has got a tweak, which is a table that has hyperlinks in it. One of the reasons why we've used a tweak, students can be guided through the content, and especially in first year, there is quite a bit of content to get through. And sometimes they can feel a little bit overwhelmed by the amount of information they have to work through and know. So each one of these red titles is a hyperlink. The way this lecturer has set up this course, the lecture has the lecture content inside it. There is also activities that the academic will do when teaching. There are also weekly readings, tutorial activities, and these two columns refer to the assessment, which goes over a period of weeks that allows them to develop skills and understandings and build a network within the course. So I'll take you through and just show you how it's all set out. So students would click into the title and they will be taken where they've got the lecture activity and the tutorial activity and the lecture slides, PowerPoint version and a PDF version. So this is to show you that if students are using mobile devices, they can access through the left-hand navigation bar as well. So let's have a look at one of the activities. What we're using is an answer garden. It's just some embedded HTML or ask students some questions. There is a 20 character minimum. You can certainly get quite a lot of information as you can see from here. So if I look at sleep, I can see that two people have said sleep, whereas people find that their favourite activity overwhelmingly is travelling. A lot of the features in Blackboard 9 are not so different to what was in Blackboard 8, but they're just a little bit easier to use. What I'm about to show you is the interview. You just go in, they've got some instructions. One is showing all the questions, and what you end up with is some very nice information. The convener who runs this course uses the results in a PowerPoint. So this is using GeoBatch, a website, and it shows the number of people in the class that live or come from certain parts of the world. And from the survey you can see their first language is predominantly English, and what other languages do you speak? And these are just using tools on the web. This one is Wordle and this one is Wordit, and this is using a graph in Word. So different ways of presenting information. That's using the survey or the test tool in Blackboard 9. This recording is going to show you two things about Blackboard 9, and this is an example of a test that you can do in Blackboard 9. As you can see, there is nothing here underneath the tab of adaptive release. And what I'm going to show you is just how adaptive release works. I'm going into the quiz. By going into the quiz, I've got some instructions. Click to begin. It's a multiple choice. And the question is adaptive release easy to do? Yes, if you know how. Yes, even without instructions. And yes. So I say yes if you know how, because I think once you know how, you'll be right. And you just go OK to confirm. Come up and it's going to tell me that I've completed it, because there was only one question. It tells me that I can press OK to view the results. So that was my feedback, probably could have given it a little bit more. Then once I've pressed OK, it's going to take me back to that. And now you can see that I've got a congratulations. It's thinking, and here's a video that pops up. Now this could show students like I have, so that is adaptive release. That's a handy thing to do, so you can create little videos. Students in the new Blackboard have My Marks. Now I'll just show you what that looks like for students. When I click on Events Proposal, I can see that there's a nice description there for them to read through. They know what the assessment is, and I've just copied and pasted that straight from the course profile. Then you've got the due date, when the student last updated it, And then you can see here there is this handy rubric, but also if you want to give them just some pretty quick comment, you can see here that there is a quick comment which you can add in at the in the mark center. Also this view rubric, and there's space for more feedback. Down the bottom there's more space for more feedback. And to get out, you simply exit. But there's a lot of information and it can all be done online. Narrating content helps students with their memory as it provides the information in context. It tells a story about the information that they are to learn and provides them links. So it's a very engaging way to present your content, especially content-rich areas where there's lots of information, such as this one with anatomy. There are red pieces of text which are hyperlinks, and as you hover over them, they'll give you an idea of what's actually in there. Some of them are definitions, and some of them are part, and some of them are different ways you can engage with the content. So I've included some interesting ways that you can engage the outside world with your course, and this is called Visible Tweets. And what it's doing is searching the internet for anything with your hashtag that you create. So you create a unique hashtag, in this instance week one, and you can pose questions and you can also get your students to respond to that hashtag, and it will collate it for you. And it's just another way to present information and provide students ways that they can give feedback. Now, I've included a video here for you which has been used or has been embedded using the mashup tool in the new Blackboard 9, and as you can see, it comes with some very good information and also the URL. And what I've now got is some questions underneath the video, so the video is actually there for a purpose. And by clicking on the red text, it's now going to take me to another place that allows me to engage with my colleagues and my lecturer. And I can see here that somebody has already posted, and to reply you just simply click the reply button. Now, this allows students to go back to information really easily, because it can be quite easy to get lost on a Learning at Griffith side, and that's why using a table can also assist in that. By laying the information out in a structured, pedagogically sound way.